let's talk about row-level security policies, or RLS. Wait, don't click away just yet. It's totally not as scary as it used to be, thanks to some awesome AI tooling that just dropped. We're gonna get into all of that, as well as how you can test these policies for a specific user. But firstly, what is RLS? No, not RL Stein, RLS, or row-level security. It's a super powerful way that you can implement authorization directly in your Postgres database. So let's say we have a table for blog posts, but we only want to display the published ones on our site. We could write an RLS policy to say only allow the user to select rows where the is underscore published column is set to true. Now, rather than baking that logic into our application, we can just select everything from the post table, and RLS will automatically filter that down to just the posts that this specific user should be able to see. To make it even less scary, you can just think of this as a where clause that's automatically appended to your queries. Okay, I'm sold. I hope you're sold. How do we actually enable RLS? You can turn it on in the Supabase dashboard under Authentication and then Policies. So we see this big scary warning saying that we should have RLS enabled, and we can enable it for each of our tables individually. Another way we could enable this is over in the SQL editor. We could just ask Supabase AI, enable RLS for the posts table. And then we can accept this new change, which is going to alter our table posts to enable row level security. That sounds like what we want. So let's click run, we get success, no rows returned. And if we go back to authentication and then policies, we can see that RLS is now enabled. Now, something that may be a little confusing if you're new to RLS is that by default, it denies all requests to the database. So no one can select, insert, update, or delete any rows. So it looks like our application is broken because we're now getting back an empty array when we ask for all of our posts. This is about as far as most people get. And then they switch it off again, everything works, and they decide, cool, I'll just avoid using RLS from now on because it breaks my application, but not anymore. If we want to enable one of those actions, like selecting all posts that have been published, we just need to write a policy. So let's create a new policy. And here we can create a policy from scratch, or if we don't have any text there, we can press tab to accept this template, or we can open up this chat interface with Supabase AI. And we can say, allow read access to the posts table if is underscore published column is true. And this looks good. We're creating a policy called this on the post table for the select action using the expression is underscore published equals true. This expression is evaluated for every single row we're trying to select. If it evaluates to true, awesome, we can select that row. If it evaluates to false, then RLS will continue denying access. So we're enabling the select action, but only for published posts. So we can click here to apply these changes, and we can see this diffing view. So we're removing these lines we had before and adding the suggestion from Supabase AI. So we can click accept and then save policy to run this SQL against our Postgres database. And we now have a policy to enable read access to published posts. And now our application is working correctly. When we select all of those posts, we're just getting back the one that's been published. So if we go over to the table editor and select the post table, we can see we have two posts. One of them has been published and the other has not. So we can now see what this would look like for different roles. We have the Postgres role, which is the default role used by the Supabase dashboard. So this has admin privileges and also bypasses RLS. We can select the anon role. So this is what it will look like for users who are not logged in. And we can see since this will respect our RLS policies, we can now only see the blog post that has been published. And if we select the authenticated role, we can see what this would look like for a specific user. So if I select that user, this is the exact data that this user would get back if they queried Supabase for all of the posts. But this isn't limited to just what the user can see for this table, but any action we want to perform. So if I try to insert a new row, and we'll just leave the default values for each of these and click save, we can see this new row violates row level security policy for table posts. So we've written a policy to enable the select action, but the insert action is still being denied by RLS. So let's write a policy. For this one, we only want the user to be able to insert a blog post that belongs to them. So we're gonna need a new column for the user who owns this post. And the name of this one can be user underscore ID. And we're gonna add a foreign key relation to the auth schema and reference the users table. This is the table used by Supabase to keep a track of our users and their sessions. We can leave everything else as is and click save and scroll down to make sure that allow nullable is enabled and click save to add that column. And now we can add our insert policy. So go back to authentication and then policies and then create new policy. So we want our user to be authenticated if they're inserting data into the database. And we also only want them to insert data for themselves. So we want them to be the owner of the post that they're trying to add. Let's get Supabase AI to help us out. So we can say allow insert on posts table if user underscore ID column matches the authenticated user's ID. And we can see this is creating a policy for the post table to enable the insert action when the user underscore ID column matches the result of this auth.uid function. So this is a special Supabase function that gives us back the ID of the user trying to perform this action. So if that ID matches the user underscore ID column, then they're trying to insert a post that belongs to them. So let's apply these changes, and we can click accept and then save policy to run that SQL. And now if we go back to the table editor and select the post table, we can change our role to the authenticated role and select our john@supabase.com user. And now if we try to insert a new row, and let's change is published to true because our select policy will only allow us to read back posts that have been published. And now if we leave the user underscore ID column blank and click save to insert that row, we get this error that new row violates row level security policy for table posts. And that's because this user underscore ID column needs to match our currently signed in user. So if we add the ID for our John user and then click save, we can see our new post has been added to the database. And our database is now secured with RLS, meaning the user is only able to perform the actions we have explicitly written a policy for. And we don't even have to write the policies. Let the robots write the policies. And with all that extra time, why not take your RLS knowledge to the next level by checking out this video right here. We look at using subqueries and joins to write more complex policies that can even enforce policies from other tables. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.